Welcome back, students. This is Meghasham Raju, Engineering College, Bikaner, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Department. Now, we have seen the surface measurement, metrology of the surface. And in that, we have seen the introduction, then what are the topology, terminology used in surface metrology, roughness, waviness, lay, flaw, surface texture, error of forms, then I have taken one example and I have explained roughness, waviness and what is the direction of the wave, manufacturing process, then analysis of the surface traces, like different methods to measure the roughness, three types of measurements and comparative chart. Then symbolic representation of the lay and surface texture symbol, everything I have explained in the previous lecture. Now, coming to the surface finish measurement. In this surface finish measurement, there are actually two types. One is either you can compare it and you can measure it. Next, the second method is direct measurement. The former measurement, which is nothing but the comparison method, you can measure it by either by observation or by feel or by the touch. But to be frank, these comparison method is not reliable. We can't rely on this measurement. Why? Because it is having the major drawbacks, like the surface may be deceptive. What is meant by deceptive? If you are taking the two surfaces and if you are comparing them, they might look like same, but actually they are not. And moreover, if you just want to measure the height difference between those two work pieces, then you should have some other method. You have to again rely on the other method, like direct measurement. And one more thing is, touch is perhaps a better method than visual observation, right? However, this method is also subjective in nature and depends to a large extent on the judgment of the person, and therefore it is also not reliable. So if you just want to measure the surface finish by using the comparison method, you should be very good. You should have a good technical knowledge. First thing is. The second thing is, like, there should not be too much errors between the two comparative work pieces. Fine. So these are the disadvantages of the former method, which is comparison method. So these limitations have driven metrology experts to devise ways and means of directly measuring surface texture by employing direct methods. So direct method is nothing but you will get some numerical value, but in comparative measurement that you will be getting some non-dimensional value. Fine. So direct measurement is way better than comparison measurement. So one of the method to measure the finish of the surface is the stylus system of measurement. In this stylus system of measurement, you will be having one stylus. Along with that stylus, you will be having one skid, or you can call it as a shoe. So this is a most popular method to measure the surface finish. A stylus generally draws along the surface of the workpiece, generates the electrical signal that are proportional to the dimension of the aspirant. I'll just show you. So this is the aspirant here, and this is the stylus, and along with the stylus you will be having a skid. So this is the aspirant here. So now the output can be generated on a hard copy unit or stored on some magnetizable media This enables extraction of measurable parameters from the data, which can quantify the degree of surface roughness. The following are the features of the stylus. So what are the features it is having are, as I have already told, it contains the skid or issue draw out the workpiece surface such that it follows the general contour of the surface as accurately as possible. So this skid will follow the contour of the workpiece, and the stylus, which is a movable element vertically with respect to the skid, so that irrespective of the waviness of the workpiece, it can measure the finish of the surface. That's what he told here. A stylus that moves over the surface along with the skid such that its motion is vertical relative to the skid, a property that enables stylus to capture the contour of surface roughness independent of the surface waviness. So independent of the surface waviness, this stylus captures the whatever roughness is there over the workpiece. Along with the, with that, it also has an amplifier which is used for the magnification of the signals, and a recorder device to produce a trace or record of the surface profile, a means for analyzing the profile thus obtained. So this is an example of a stylus system which is generally used to measure the finish of the surface.